मैं मसरत मिसबा हूँ, देखते रहिए टोरंटो 360 टीवी।
हम वी के ज़ेर एहतमाम आज मैपल बैंक्वेट हॉल में एक फंड रेजिंग डिनर का एहतमाम किया गया है। पाकिस्तान की मुमताज़ ब्यूटिशियन जनाब मसरत मिसबा साहबा यहाँ पे इसमें मौजूद होंगी। उनकी फाउंडेशन है स्माइल अगेन फाउंडेशन। तेज़ाब से जो बच्चियाँ जल जाती हैं या जिन्हें केरोसिन ऑयल से मिट्टी के तेल से जला दिया जाता है, उनके लिए ख़ास तौर पर ये काम कर रही हैं। उनकी सर्जरीज़ के लिए, उनकी रिहेबिलिटेशन के लिए, उनके ट्रेनिंग के लिए मुख्तलिफ प्रोग्राम्स ये फाउंडेशन कर रही है। आज इस हवाले से यहाँ में सागा में एक एहतमाम किया गया है। सादे खालिद साहबा, तहिया नईम साहबा और उनके बहुत से दोस्तों ने यहाँ पर इसका एहतमाम किया है। खासे लोग यहाँ मौजूद हैं, 250-300 लोग यहाँ पे हैं और हमें उम्मीद है कि बहुत शानदार और कामयाब फंड रेजिंग होगा। इसके मेज़बान जो फंड रेजर करेंगे अवैस इकबाल साहब हैं, कैमरामैन हमारे साथ साबिर गाय हैं। इसके तमाम डिटेल आप तक प्रोग्राम में पहुंचाएंगे और उसके बाद क्लोजिंग तरफ आपको लिए चलेंगे। कैमरामैन साबिर गाय के साथ अरशद भट्टी, मेपल बैंक्वेट हॉल मिसेस आगा से।
अस्सलामुअलैकुम, मैं हूँ सादिया खालिद। आज हमारा प्रोग्राम हो रहा है, हमारा इवेंट 28 जून डिप्लेक्स स्माइल फाउंडेशन के लिए, जो कि डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस और एब्यूज़ के एक वर्स्ट फॉर्म है, एसिड अटैक विक्टिम्स। और हमारी बहुत ही प्यारी रिस्पेक्टेबल मेहमान हैं जो पाकिस्तान से आई हुई हैं, मुसरत मिसबा, जो वहाँ पर एक एनजीओ रन कर रही हैं, जो कि हमारी एक बहुत ही प्यारी मेकअप आर्टिस्ट भी हैं, उनकी अपनी मेकअप लाइन भी है। और हमने वो हमारे हम वी के इन्विटेशन पर कैनेडा तशरीफ़ लाई और हमने उनके लिए एक काफ़ी मेहनतों के बाद एक इवेंट हमने मुनक्कद किया, जो जिसमें हम उनके जो काम कर रही हैं वो पाकिस्तान में एसिड अटैक विक्टिम्स के लिए या केरोसिन ऑयल बर्न के लिए, बर्न विक्टिम्स के लिए, उसमें हम उनको फंड रेज करने के लिए यहाँ पर जमा हुए हैं हम सारे लोग। और हमारी कोशिश है कि हम इस आज उनको उन तमाम ख्वातीन के लिए हम यहाँ से कनाडा के लोगों की, कनाडा में जो कम्युनिटी है पाकिस्तानी, बल्कि हमारे इस इवेंट में ना सिर्फ पाकिस्तानी कम्युनिटी है बल्कि हमारे नॉन पाकिस्तानी कम्युनिटी भी यहाँ पर जमा है और वो मुसरत मिसबा की ज़ुबानी सुनने के लिए बेचैन है कि वो वहाँ पर उन ख्वातीन के लिए क्या काम कर रही हैं और किस तरह से उन ख्वातीन की मदद कर रही हैं। हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हम वी ने उनको यहाँ पर बुलाया ताकि हम उनके लिए फंड्स इकट्ठे करें। और मेरी इस काविश में, हमारी सारी कोशिशों में हमारी तमाम टीम मेंबर्स शामिल हैं। हमारा टोरंटो 360 नंबर 1 है और मेरी तमाम जो टीम है उसमें ताहिया नईम, जिनके ये इनिशिएटिव है सबसे पहला, जिन्होंने इसको मुझ तक पहुंचाया और हमारी पूरी टीम ने इसको आगे बढ़ाया।
Can talk to the founder and the members of this organization. So first of all, you know, thank you very much for organizing this beautiful show here, the event, and I know how much it takes to get something like this going. So why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
We are humbled. Thank you so much for coming and attending this event, because this event means a lot for Humvee, because we are heading towards a better step to support Musarrat Misbah's Diplex Smile Again Foundation back home in Pakistan. So my name is Sadia Khalid, as you all know, and I run Humvee organization. I'm an executive director for of the organization, and we have 5 board members of board of directors. One of them is sitting, but my 2 members are sitting on the other table, which I should recognize. I must recognize and acknowledge their support for me, Khushnigar Sayed and Uruba and Babar. These are my backbones, and I'm nothing without them. So thank you so much.
Good evening everyone. Assalamu alaikum. Hiya Naeem, and I'm from Karachi, Pakistan. My background is textile designing, and when I came here from Dubai, so I just feel that my field, I have to change it in a second career as a art and craft teacher. So I did that job, and right now I am with Humvee and Sadia Khalid, so I'm working with them.
Sadia, why don't you please help us understand, put things in perspective? What is the purpose of this Humvee organization, and are you focusing on just the Canadian causes or international causes? What is the purpose?
Actually, we started in 2017, we registered our organization, and since then we are working for South Asian community, and that was the main purpose, but we are open for anyone, not really South Asian, but because I am from South Asian background and I know my culture and custom very well, and that's why we started it. But let me say, when we started it, it was just because we wanted to do something for the community, some productive work for the community. But when we started working and interacting with our community, we realized that there is a lot of work to be done in South Asian community. There are very too much stigmas, taboos are still there, and we, since 2015, we are struggling, and we can't believe that it's 2019 and we are facing domestic violence and abuse in 2019. So we think we started working to break the taboo. But we are, number one, there are three purposes of our organization. Number one is obviously the advocacy. We create awareness about domestic violence and abuse in South Asian community. Number two is to provide services like counseling. We provide counseling to our clients, to the victims, which is free. Number third is to help them in rehabilitation. And we have, so far out of seven, we have managed to rehabilitate four women in South Asian community who have the South Asian background, in terms of psychological help, in terms of financial and legal, all three areas. And how we are doing that, don't ask.
So Tahia, question to you is, what was the key reason to partner with Dipilix Ismail Again organization for this fundraiser?
First of all, Masarat ma'am is a role model for me, because everyone knows that she has done a lot for acid burn victims, and this issue is not heard in any country just like in Pakistan, right? And we just work for South Asian communities, and Masarat Mizbah done very well, and they support them very well. So that's how I feel, that as a human being, or as a being a woman, I feel the pain and that domestic violence, because I said that this form, like acid attacks, are a worst form of domestic violence, right? So why don't we raise our voice over here? Because she registered her organization in Pakistan, UK and USA, but not in Canada. So I feel that we have to do something. So I just discussed with Sadia about this initiative, and she said, yes, we have to do that, because it's also related to Humvee, because this is like domestic violence and abuse. So that's how we connect Masarat Mizbah and Sadia Khalid. So I would like to thanks Humvee, Sadia Khalid, and all our other my board of directors, just like Aruba, Khushnigar, and Babar, because they accepted my request and they worked hard for this event as well.
And that day finally came.
Exactly.
We are welcoming Masarat Mizbah, who's the pride of Pakistan.
Yes.
So thank you very much for your effort.
I am Rima Khan, an empowered Pakistan. So are they. जड़ी है सिर्फ ताकत नहीं, दूसरों का दुख दूर करने की, ऐसे ऐसा मुमकिन किया स्माइल अगेन के साथ.
मैं असरबत सरबावर हूँ और एक ब्यूटिशियन.
मैं बाहुनर हूँ, आज जो उठती हूँ डी एस एफ की वजह से हूँ. थैंक यू डी एस एफ.
मैं एक बहिमत माँ हूँ, मुझे ये हौसला स्माइल अगेन प्रोविजन ने दिया है.
मुझे वो लोगों को खूबसूरत बनाने का हुनर डी एस एफ ने दिया है.
डिप्लेट स्माइल अगेन फाउंडेशन हमारा मुफ्त इलाज करवा रहा है.
अब अम्मा अपने हाथों से सब काम कर सकते हैं.
Because he wants me to do this for his.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम. बहुत शुक्रिया आप सब लोगों का. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर बीइंग हियर एंड फॉर सपोर्टिंग अ कॉज विच इज़ सो नियर एंड डियर टू माय हार्ट. थैंक यू.
सो व्हाई डोंट यू प्लीज टेल अस बिट मोर अबाउट योरसेल्फ, वेयर आर यू फ्रॉम, योर फैमिली, सो वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू आर ऑल्सो वन लाइक ह्यूमन बींग.
येस आई थिंक सो. ओके जी, आई एम मसरत मिसबा एंड I've been in the field of beauty for the last 40 years. It's a long time. When I started, I was a single parent at that time, very young. and my parents gave me an option of continuing with my studies or whatever I wanted to do. I said, no, no, Daddy ji, main apna kaam khud karna chahti hoon. Main apne bachchon ko palna chahti hoon. So it was maybe 17 and a half years old when I started my business, of course, with the help and support of my parents, my family. And then there was no looking back, but there's always an incident that even at that time, that is way back in 1990, women working in our society was a bit difficult. People would not look at them kindly, and especially certain businesses which were not really, actually they were looked down upon, and being beautician was one of them. I got my vocational training and education from abroad, and when I came back, my family, invested in a salon for me, and I used to drop my children to the school and would, you know, open up my salon 8:30 in the morning. Nobody would be up and about at that time, and I remember that there was this lady. When I went to introduce myself, she actually banged the door on me and said, now, your kind of women are going to spoil my whole atmosphere, my mohalla, mera neighborhood, and don't even come near me. And I was like taken aback. I was young. I was not expecting, this kind of attitude. And so I said, okay, fine. And in the morning when I used to walk up to open my salon, this lady would be coming down, going maybe to her office and all, and I would say, Assalamu alaikum, and she would go, hmm. You know, she was very unhappy with me. And after 3 years of every day asking her to, I would say, Assalamu alaikum, and she would refuse to answer me back. 3 years afterwards, she walked into my office, and she says, oh, so you are educated. You have got certificates and all. I said, gee, thank you. Assalamu alaikum. How are you? And how come I see you? Kehti, well, this is my daughter. And train her and teach her to be what you are. Back, I started empowering women at that time when these words were not even invented. I also had no idea what empowerment meant. The word empowerment was, it was not there. Or entrepreneurship or businesses for women. It was just that I got education, trained abroad, and the girls who were working in the salons were not actually educated enough and not trained enough. So I started training them. And now, alhamdulillah, 40 years down the lane, we've got 70 salons all over Pakistan. And in every 70 salons. And in every salon, we've got on an average 35 to 40 girls working there. And they're from very humble background, maybe lower middle classes. Behtreen bachiyan. They are qualified, they're trained, and they are amazingly empowered women. For me, they are just there and, on their own feet.
So Mike and Rick and Amber, 3,000 plus employment opportunities created by her saloon, 70 branches across Pakistan. So that is definitely an awesome thing. And we'll talk about it, how the further employment opportunities were created for people, those who are victim of acid burn attacks. So we'll talk about it. So next one is, how this journey started from a successful beautician to somebody who is now serving the humanity. How this all started?
I would say that God, Allah Ta'ala, gives you opportunities to help. It's up to us how much we would like to help and how little we would like to help. The opportunities are there for you, and whatever, alhamdulillah, Allah Ta'ala has given you, we should always be grateful and thankful to Him. Because main ye samajhti hu ke jo kuch usne hame nawaz diya hai wo hum is qabil nahi hai, aur jitna hum shukr ada kare wo kam hai. Itna shukr ada kare har waqt कि आपकी जुबान जो है वो लकड़ी की भी तरह खुश्क हो जाए तो वो कभी कम है. सो यू नो लेट्स बी वेरी वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू अल्लाह फॉर ऑल दैट ही हैज गिवन अस. So it was one of these days. I am very passionate about my work. I am the first one to enter my salon and last one to leave also, even today. Now when I say even today, please do not look at my gray hair. I've colored them. So I was leaving my salon, and as I was about to leave, this girl walked in. She was all clad up in her burqa, in a veil. Her face was covered, and I could see that she's from a humble background because uski chaple bhi tooti phooti si thi. And then she said to me, please help me. Well, she didn't use word please, she said help me. And I said to her, matlab mujhe acha nahi laga, mujhe laga ye kaisi badtameezi se baat kar. So I said to her, okay, please come tomorrow, and I thought that maybe she's there to, for me to maybe help her financially. And she says, no, aap jo itni badi beautician bani phirti hai, mujhe theek kariye. And she removed her veil, and in front of me was a girl without a face. It was a girl who had actually lost one eye. There was a hole instead of her nose. Her chin and neck were contractured. Her this hand was okay, but her this side was really badly affected. And you believe me that this was the first time that I actually encountered an acid attack victim. I was standing and I sat down because I thought there was no life left in my legs, you know. I just sat down, very wobbly. And then I asked her, I said, what has happened to you? And she says, somebody has thrown acid and you claim to be the beautician, so you make me look good. And so it took me a while. I went into my office, pani shani peeke, then I came out and I said, okay, let me help you. And I started calling my colleagues, my friends, my clients' husbands who were doctors. Unfortunately, at that time, it was like 7:30, 8 o'clock in the evening. Most of the people wouldn't pick up the phone. Or if the doctors were busy, maybe in their private clinics, and some of them who did answer me back, said that please bring her tomorrow. So I told her, I said, "Acha solo subha, when I come in the morning, I'll take you there." And she says, okay. And I said, "Ab, you can leave now." And she says, where do I go? And I said, I'm sorry. And she says, no, you help me. Give me a shelter now. I have to admit that I regret even this today, that I was very frightened also. And meri bahut soch choti thi, you know. I thought ki pata nahi iske peeche kaun log aage honge, main isko ghar nahi le ja sakti. I didn't have the guts to actually take her home. So I said, okay, you stay here. And I went back, and that was the turning point in my life. That day when I went back home, मैंने अल्लाह ताला से माफ़ी मांगी गिड़गड़ा के. I was like, why did I not see all these things before? It was not that these kind of issues or incidents I've never heard, read or seen, but I would be like, oh my God, you know, this is really bad. And khatam, you know, that was the day when my everything changed for me. मैंने जहाँ अल्लाह ताला से माफ़ी मांगी फॉर नॉट लुकिंग इन टू दीज मैटर्स, एट द सेम टाइम आई एक्चुअली थैंक गॉड ऑल्सो फॉर हिम टू बी प्रोवाइडिंग मी ऑल दैट ही इज़ गिवन मी, बिकॉज मैं इस काबिल ही नहीं हूँ, ना पहले थी ना आज हूँ. लेकिन मुझे ये पता है कि नाउ दैट गॉड हैज़ गिवन मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू हेल्प, आई हैव टू हेल्प हर, एंड आई कुड अफोर्ड टू हेल्प हर. इट वॉज ओनली आफ्टर 15-20 डेज दैट I realized that if I could help one girl, maybe I can help some more girls. And I placed an ad in the newspaper saying that if you're an acid or kerosene oil burnt victim, come to Deplex on such and such date. 42 girls walked in that day. 42 girls. And my legs were wobbly because I couldn't take it. And that particular day, I just, you know, sat down again because I thought, oh God, I've asked for few girls, but this is too many, you know. I it was difficult for me to. But then Allah Ta'ala says ke wo aapko utna hi wazan deta hai jitna aap sahar sakte hain. You can only, he will just give you ample and enough for you to take forward the way or the job that he's given you. So I started, and I had no idea, but I started filing, registering them. And then in 2005, I registered my organization as a non-profit NGO organization. And now since 2005,
although I started in 2003, but since 2005 till today, we have got more than 760 girls registered with us.
My name is Ujala Feroz. My name is Nicole Feroz.
My name is Aisha Butt.
And my name is Khadija Naeem.
And you're watching Toronto 360.
Ji, mera naam Nazia Afzal hai. Dekhte rahiye Toronto 360 TV. Hum dobara hazir hote hain ek chote se commercial break ke baad.